How did you meet Solar?
Oh, man, I met him at a rally, man. You know, we hold rallies every end of the month, the Nation of Gods and Earth. So up on Harriet Tubman School, up on 127th and 7th Avenue. So one of my brethren, he was like, yo, this brother, you know, he produces. You hot. I know you rocking with Guru. You know, why don't you hear his tracks? So I listened to a couple of his tracks. I was like, all right, meet me down on 48th. We down in the studio doing what we do. You know, we'll get it in. So Solar came down. And from the jump, he was like, you know, arrogant, wanting to bogart everything, you know, just, you know, no kind of coof. But I was like, all right, whatever. Maybe he's just, you know, a little starstruck or whatever. You know, he's over anxious. Let's just get the work done.
Uh-huh. Guru didn't know Solar at that time.
No, he didn't know Solar at that time. No. He didn't know Solar until I brung Solar. Solar was my producer. And when I saw the interviews before he came and did this, because you told me something about Solar, I told you that I introduced you to him.
Yeah.
But in the beginning, he wasn't saying that in the blogs and all of that, like 2005 and all of that stuff.
Solar said, how did you meet Guru? And he said he was working with you,
right.
Black Jesus. He was producing tracks, and we went in a studio, and he met Guru. And at that point, they had, you know, they hit it off, so to speak. You know, they had a good chemistry, creative chemistry. And at that time, Guru was at a point in his career where he was looking for some different things and opportunities. I'm paraphrasing to a certain extent, but because they had that chemistry, they stayed in contact from that point on.
Nah, you see, that right there is like exaggerating the whole situation, if I can put it correct. I mean, you know, the chemistry, because he's gangsta. Mm-hmm. That's the sound, what they do. I mean, he does his jazzmatazz thing and does different things, but the whole thing is he was producing for me. Because at the same time he was doing the owners, he was working on my project.
Guru was.
Guru, yeah. Mm-hmm. He was multitasking. Mm-hmm. So at the same time he was working on the owners album, we were working on my joint. I mean, I filmed footage from my video on the Skills video set when they went BK. At the Armory, filming the Skills video. Mm-hmm. I did my scenes with Guru in my video, to be in my video, on the set of Skills. So it was a chemistry that we had, and I hate to say it, you know, with the buzz that we were getting with it, they kind of hated it and wanted to run with the chemistry.
Mm-hmm.
I could show you all of the reviews that they got for doing their stuff. I'm not trying to hate, but a lot of people is like, you know, that's not what he's supposed to be doing.
Where was the relationship between DJ Premier? This is about year 2001, 2002, or?
Oh, when we did the Bullhead Slick was 2001. Yeah. So 2002, yeah. When
about,
Solar came in, yeah, 2002.
Where was the relationship with DJ Premier and Guru at that point?
Well, I mean, you know, the brother complained to me a few times about the old Primo this, and I just looked at it like, look, brother, that's you and your crew. That's not really my business. You know, you guys need to, you know, put your different whatever if you're going through, whatever you're going through. You know, put it aside. Let's get a Gangsta album put out. You know what I'm saying? I was like, you know,
was it creative differences? Was it Guru didn't feel like he had enough attention? Were they just moving in two different directions?
I think it was the fact, if you want me to be honest, it was the fact of the beats. Because he told me a couple of times, oh, man, because, you know, when Guru steps off and they're not doing Gangsta, he does his jazzmatazz or the Ill Kid stuff, and, you know, Prem goes and hits off Jadakiss and Nas and Hova and all of them. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I think it was maybe a little jealousy of you know, that was supposed to be our beats for that project, and you gave it to them. Little normal stuff. You know, there's going to be a little, you know, little animosity between that. I didn't look at it like that. I was like, what y'all do is something totally different. I feel you getting all of the hottest tracks if you ask me.